Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the EIZO Cup number 10 grand final game number 2. We have VirtusPro going up against RoX. I'm a little bit late starting into this one because we're organizing some passwords to be sent out to the people who won the 1v1 competition. But we are here now into our draft, so we'll have our draft already underway and a long way underway. So I haven't done a speed draft in a while, but we're not really at the point where we have to speed draft. So basic stuff. Venomancer, Pugnet, Doom, Timbersaw. Goldblack, stick him with his bands. He's not going to let these guys through. Elder Titan was the one he tried to have slip through, even though knowing, like, first pick is always going to be a rough kind of guy. But ET gets through, but and then return, Bristleback, Abaddon, and now we have an OD as well. A combination which we're watching, I believe. Which team was it? It was VC Gaming, I think, ran this combination as well. They're not the only team, but it's the one team I cast recently that did it. Where you have basically the Bristleback as well as the OD. So you just basically keep spamming out your quills. OD keeps spamming off his heal. Abaddon keeps spamming off his heal. And OD says, well, have Essence Aura. Shield everybody. Do whatever you want. Everybody has mana. Was basically the way it approaches it. And then VP, to go with a pickup like a Lich, I give him props for this, but this has to be a full-on team fight. Like, we're talking Darkseer, Vag into Enigma, Black Hole, Elder Titan, ulti, Lich, ulti, bouncing around kind of like team fight level that they need to hit with this. So, yeah, it's going to be a rough time for them, in my mind, because the team fight potential for Roskis, the setup for Roskis, is just so damn good right now that I'm wondering. I really do wonder if VirtusPro have what it takes to take this team fight. Laning wise, it's going to be a little bit better for VirtusPro because they know that RoX are going to be attempting their dual lanes again, which is just like Abaddon supports one person, Bristleback gets supported by one person, and they go in for the Weaver, so we try and go for Light of Heaven's carry again Weaver, or is it going to be Illidan this time around? And then Light of Heaven takes up the Elder Titan role because it can't be a support Elder Titan in this game. It just can't be. If it is, there's not enough stuns, there's not enough control. Rubick is still very highly favored in this pool, I would say. Especially for RoX. They got a Weaver on the field and a Lich on the field. If you can grab Lich's ultimate, hell yes, you will want to be able to do that. And Rubick hasn't been touched. Crystal Man was banned out by Illidan, in fact, so Arsar can't go for his stocks and the hero, and they're actually going with the Dazzle. Oops, sorry. I know that's just destroying people's ears. They go with the Dazzle. Which means, hey, he's not banned out yet. He's not banned out yet. My points is on Slaughter. My points are on Slaughter right now. Amplified damage with the goo. It's a shame RoX aren't actually over on, I don't know, even then, like, no, it's just early Roshan. It wouldn't help him if they were over on the dice side. Boom! Called it! Yes! I have failed so badly in the semifinals for today, but the grand final has given me divine light. I finally remember my game. Oh, it's been a fun day. It's been a fun day. I even got to have a short day today. It was Cap who had to have the long day starting at 7 a.m. and going to the end. But he doesn't leave here anyway. He doesn't have internet at home, so he wants to stay here anyway. Yeah, but Enigma, that's what I was talking about. I don't know if they'll do the whole Darkseer as well combination in, because they were the two heroes I called, but they've got to grab them all in. Viper would be the last man to hear from Goldblack. He's thinking about the middle lane, because that is VP's last lane. They're not going to go a Darkseer. This is an Elder Titan. Elder Titan could technically run in the middle lane up against the OD, but it's not going to be that great, especially with the nerf to Elder Titan Spirit. It's only 20 damage, but 20 damage can make or break a team. Like, with the smoke rotation in from Lich as well as Enigma, you could catch somebody out. They could even try and run Enigma as a core, because you're looking at dual deny lanes here. So you could even run Enigma on the off lane if you so desired. You could run Enigma and Lich down that on that bottom lane, put the Elder Titan supporting and pulling on the top. You can put him as a carry roll and then get another supporter into this. I'm down with that. That's no problem at all, because then your cores become Enigma, Weaver, Elder Titan. That's still okay. It just means in the later portion of the game, if the Weaver does not have farm, you're totally boned. We got Mag. Mag would be a nice pickup. Shockwave to get the farm. You'll need to have your bottle up nice and fast. But that'll be a nice way to go. I just realized I'm not hearing the wonderful voices. Yeah, we go. Let's turn on our in-game audio. Slark will be the final selection here for RoX. So Goldblatt gets to go with his kind of guy. They got two heroes, which are very, very difficult to kill off. But two heroes, which can be controlled by the Black Hole. And because there's very few stunners, like if you look at this entire lineup from Rox Kiss, what have they got to stop the hole?
10 seconds remaining.
And just spent. Basically it. Nyx Assassin will be their final one. So VP going to get a little bit more standard with this one. Yeah. But Scandal gets a Slark, so he'll take the solo mid-roll. Line of Heaven is on that Elder Titan, so it'll be Slark going up against Nyx Assassin. They may switch around, but I doubt it. Goldblack does like to play his Abaddon. So into the game we go. And up to the top we head. I'll see VirtusPro. So Arsart will take the jungle hero in this. We'll have Illidan as the Weaver. We'll have Jotam as the Lich. But Sergei got over on our Nyx Assassin, and Light of Heaven takes up the role as the Elder Titan. While up on the top lane, we've got Yol already preparing as a... What, Yol? Huh, interesting. Very interesting. Again, BZZ's going to switch over to the support. This is now the third time I've watched him play Dazzle. And he's going to be supporting Yol on the bottom lane. So the roles switch around a little bit. And then Scandal in the middle. He'll be not be babysat by Goldblack. Goldblack's probably going to be moving out just to ward for the moment. Goldblack's main priority is going to be making sure Cedoy stays alive. But there's some really good lane switches up from Roxkiss. Illidan's going to have a real hard time on that top lane. Because the second he wants to initiate an OD, like OD will just start pulling his mana away, which means those right clicks to Illidan are really going to hurt. And 60 mana to cast off a Shikuchi, you'll basically get one done, you'll be out of mana, and you'll lose your maneuverability. Lich has to, yeah, he's already moving up towards the top lane. They don't know these lanes are happening. Like, the Dire Observer is there, and they're watching Goldblack down here on the bottom lane. But Lich... it's going to have to move quickly towards that top lane if they want to try and save themselves from the OD.
The battle begins.
Ah, nice room. VZZ. That level one poison is really, really good. Look at this. This is just from the quick engagement. He's down half of his life points. This is a level one poison touch. That's the level of buff it was given. Is Cedoy actually going to go? No, he's not. Goldblack, and he put the ward. There's one observer ward down. Yeah, he had to plant the second one. Up on top of the hill. So watch the rotation coming up towards the top lane. Illidan might try and compete up against this, but now he's like, oh, I got no D on my top lane, peoples. And now, as well, in Abaddon, someone send the support. Someone send the cavalry. Sergei and Scandal. Oh, Scandal. Hey, look at him. He's just stolen. He has 18 plus right now in his agility. At the level 1, all attribute loss, gain. Like, it's gained by 3 for every single one. That's why you're seeing it just disappear for a moment. But he's able to shift so many points of that essence over, which means when he attacks on Sergei, Sergei's lost all of his agility. And Nyx Assassin is an agility hero. So he really needs that in order to get any kind of last hits. Right now, he's 2-0 up against a 2-3. But you got Scandal playing with a full creep wave, or in fact, a double creep wave coming his way. Which is the reason why this lane has basically just been won by Slark. Controls the creep wave, he controls the Nyx Assassin. Nyx Assassin has his bottle coming in, that's gonna be nice for him. But the mana burn doesn't really stop the Slark. Like, the stuns and initiation, once it's up to a certain level, then it will be enough. But, like, God can't hope to really get a kill here in this middle lane, unless there's some kind of, like, screw up. By the way, how gorgeous is that dog? Look at him, they're protecting him. They're worried about the rotation. They're really worried about a rotation. And Yol down here on the bottom lane with BZZ. Remember, it's a double slow you're combining up here. One with negative armor. And one that comes through with like, it's like 10 second duration. It's, life gets really, really hard, even with that high movement speed for Light of Heaven when the spirit gets pulled back in again. Until he pulls the spirit back in, he's still insanely slow. Basically, Michael Jackson moonwalk kind of style. Which isn't really the style you want to be having. Oh, imprisonment. This is really nothing apart from just taking away Illidan's mana. I mean, you see him. He can't even Shikuchi. He has to take this damage. Is Cedo even had one level up in there? Is that enough damage? Yeah, they're going to dive this. Goldblack puts the shield off. He wanted the shield to trigger, and that's first blood. Goldblack trying to hide in the tree line. Oh, wait. Can he get out of here? He needs his shield back up again. 1 second and he can shield himself and just run. There it is. Shield and run. Get himself away to safety. Slark not looking too healthy. Sergei's right behind him. Bottle charge. Stun him 1 second. Pounce in four. He'll have to duke it. Tries to go up and down. Goes over towards the Ancients. He throws the stun. Nyx Assassin will get the kill. The Ancients not desiring to be aggro from a long range while in the bottom lane Light of Heaven. Movement down here with a snot in the touch. BZZ. Now he's realizing just how hard Light of Heaven hits. That attack is not going to be enough. The frost will be though. Y'all can't finish off Jotun by himself, but that's a better trade for RoX KIS. They bring down the offlaner of VP for the price of a Dazzle support. I'll take that trade any day. So we go 5-1 now. On callback, really? Out of six matches, I'm not surprised whatsoever. It's 2-2 on the board. Monkey see, monkey read. It's the reason why you have co-caster when you have stats, man. So you can actually read what they put there. At all other times, you can't do it. Arsas protecting the double damage rune. How's his farm? He's actually managed to pick 27 out of the jungle. Overall, the advantage is still going the way of RoX KIS. And that's probably going to be the scarier thing here for VP. Experience is going the way of VP because Enigma's obviously pulling more out of the jungle. But the fact you already have a 1,200 gold advantage going the way of RoX KIS, first blood doesn't give you that much of an advantage. It's because the CS in the lanes are completely outstripping the VP players. You got this middle lane, which is 22-7, up against a Nyx who is 8-0. He is 8-0. He's soaking up the experience, but that's basically all he's getting out of it. And then you got Yol down the bottom lane, 15-4, up against the Elder Titan, 14-0. Now, that's obviously not too bad, especially though when you take into consideration the Lich is using Sacrifice. So that's actually a hell of a lot better for the Bristleback. And then you got this top lane, where Seedoy is 25-10, up against a 9-1 Illidan. This farm's just not arriving. The team fight potential later on is what's really going to be the wonder house for VP if they can get the black hole. Just because I'm still going to sit with the whole thing, like you can't interrupt the black hole, which means you can look at a lot of different items. Yol, with BZZ, there's your poison. Jotun will die from this. Yol may also die. He's got his bristles to the back. Hop pops up the south. Light of Heaven. There's your last hit. Down to the side, jot him into the corner. The poison's still ticking, man. He's gonna try and TP out, but BZZ will get that kill. He's got another level up in he's got another poison level. Another poison, sorry, which he can trigger off. He's gonna need a Shallow Grave. Light of Heaven, if he gets one more hit, boom. There it is. And TPs. There'll be enough time to TP out to safety. And then instantly, Yol's gonna head back down to that bottom lane. And that was a wise decision coming out. That was a very wise decision coming out at the end of the day from the Dazzle. I think he realized that really what... he had a lot of mana up his sleeve, but if he tried to fight Light of Heaven then, the chances are he wouldn't have had enough mana to escape from it too. So he just decided, you know what, I'm going to try and run. Can't make the run fully, which means back up, Shallow Grave, TP out. Save the mana until he knew exactly what he wanted to do. Illidan's coming in close again. Just continues to Shikuchi. He's only got one point of the imprisonment stopping him right now, and with Arsart's rotation over, Arsart. What did he haul? What did you see, Nahaz? What the hell did he haul? We've got Scandal now rotating up towards the top lane, and Black Hole's down for now. Arsart's dead. The Leech in. He's got no way to stop this. He'll die. He gets the Malbus on everyone's seat. At least there'll be some kind of revenge. Goldblack unable to save him in time. Locked into a corner. He'll probably try and deny himself off right now. In fact, he did. But the Shallow Grave will keep him alive. Illidan chasing him down as far as he can. There's still a shield, and now a Weaver commits himself too far. The conversions are still here. Scandal's trying to pick him up before that follow up stun on the BZZ. But it's a little bit too far. Okay. Thank you very much. He used a black hole while trying to kill me. Okay. And then Slark rotates top lane and gets a kill. That's just going to be salt in the wound. Especially when it's Slark who kills off the Enigma. And Seedoy now goes into the lane where really all ODs feel a lot more comfortable. He's up against Illidan as well as Sergei. God, he knew he was too far away to hit that stun. It's such a horrible stun to try and connect as well. As we have clearly established on this broadcast multiple times, it is the hardest stun in the game to land. Yol, Frosted, No spirit coming out from Line of Heaven, so it's not a commitment to kill off Yull. It's just an attack going its way. While Slark moving up instead of smoke, he's going to rotate around the back. They're going to look for a kill on this one. Yull has to turn his back again, but in comes Slark. Light of Heaven, dead straight away. Lich throws the ulti off. There's still a bit of a creep wave here, but there's going to be maximum amount of bounces. Yull takes it down. How the hell did that reach back up again? Scandal's going to jump himself up, and Sergei comes in. Vendetta hit, plus the follow-up stun. Bristleback will take care of the Lich, but somehow Chain Frost has just managed to increase its range by 5 million. Yull battling up against Arsat. He's got Snot available, he's got a couple of quills, Malivus stun, follow stun from God. This is the death of Yull. Nyx Assassin gets a double kill. Another successful rotation coming out from God.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Arsat now going to try and take bottom tower. He can't commit, though. He doesn't have enough life points to survive. Even right now, when he uses his soul ring, he's going to drop himself down pretty low. Looks like he's not even going to do that. Pull him out and then try and kite it. Oh, Goblack as well as Seedoy prepare for the middle lane. Seedoy running hand of Midas. This must be really looking to take this into the middle of the late game. Which is the perfect timing. Yol has also now got enough money, he can finish up his full Vanguard. As if he also wants to make that choice, Light of Heaven here in the mid. BZZ, he's not going to get close enough. Also look at BZZ not leveling up his ultimate. Instead he puts 3 points. He commits his points into the poison touch over everything else. Zap. Just shows you just that, like, a duration. You basically, it's 260 damage. It's 26 damage per second. So the duration being 10 seconds. Easy. Like, easiest calculation ever. You do 260 damage. Instead of doing the base 200. Well, the 200, which is the second level. That's what he chose to go for. Now middle lane, Lich. Is there going to be the poison being thrown out? Yeah, there is. Jotun will tick out from this. But Slark wants to make sure he's dead. So Scandal will take the last hit in. While on bottom lane, there's prep being done. Arsat, this time we'll see if his Black Hole can get a kill. And this time we should be able to see it. He'll have to use it. He has to use the Black Hole if he wants to kill on Yol. Soul Ring. Oh no, he's on cooldown. He's short. Now he's got the mana, but it's too late. Supports have rotated in, the conversion's still beating down top of Yol, but Scandal's running up here, and he wants Arsat. Maybe Arsat can now use this as bait. They should be able to check his mana and realize he's got enough again. But having the Soul Ring on cooldown, he wasn't ready for this. Sergei, snotted up. Now your Black Hole time. He's too far away, though. He's being kited out. Scandal with his haste rune, leaps in, runs away. Lich Alderman bouncing down the creep wave, and over, split. Ah, BZZ, he's taking it away to safety. He's going to get back in there, though. They need his Shallow Grave. They need his heal over on Yol. Scandal locked in the corner with Sergei, battling up with Goblack. Shield's going to stop that from him from going down. Yol dying a little bit further down. And God, he does finally get that kill. BZZ has to actually throw himself into the Shallow Grave while the OD ulti helps to burn out the rest of the Enigma's life points. Abaddon through the nuke out, but now they've lost OD as well. Over to Wars aside, it's just the two supports who are on the run. VP coming out well on top of this match. BZZ, oh no, no. Nah, the pings are there. They're going to check. Yeah, it is. Hello. Dazzle goes down and Goblack will escape. RoX KIS committed everything and so did VP to that fight. And the entire time, you can see him just like jumping in. RoX KIS having the confidence to even dive back into the tier 1 tower range of VirtusPro. And it was actually RoX KIS were the first ones to be initiated on. When the Enigma trying to rotate around the back, but it was a bit of a balls up of the mana cost from Arsat. He thought he was there. I think he really, really thought he was there. He's going to lose a conversion. Yeah, he lost it. That's some decent momentum to lose from the top lane too. Couldn't attack fast enough to have it replicate back out again. But everyone gets to go back to their farming for now. Invisibility! Or can they? With an Invis rune, he's fine. With an Invis rune, he's more than fine. Might even try and initiate on Yol. Shikuchi through. Light of Heaven's in the neighborhood throwing out the spirit, but that's not going to be enough to get the full initiation off. Someone's got to deal with this Enigma on the top lane as he's pushing the tier 1 tower. Well, we got some Snot and Light of Heaven. Shield from Goldblack will be enough to allow Yol to dive this one down, which he's going to do. There's 3 levels of Snot right now on Light of Heaven. Let's make it 4. Nuke down. Scandal jumps in. Jotun, too close. This time there will be no Lich ulti, and they're going to lose 2 heroes on this bottom lane. That'll be a follow-up onto the tier 1 tower in the mid, as well as the other lane. Let's actually have a quick flashback too while we've got a little bit of a moment while these towers are going down. This is that fight in the bottom lane again. It's a bit of a replay. And that one moment where there was just not enough to fight that one up. Actually, let's go back real time. Arsat, we come straight back in the middle of a black hole. He's holding him there, but Scandal, it's not enough life points to survive it. I thought we had enough time just looking at a tier one tower trade. And all of a sudden, someone decides they want to TP into the middle of both the Nyx Assassin as well as the Enigma. Enigma who had the black hole too. Enigma will take the tower with the conversions. And they bail out. So the tower trade will be there. Okay, now we could check out the end of that engagement. Just the end. It really went all over the place at one point. Like, that ODLD dropped down. You probably thought that was going to do a hell of a lot more. Like, you get one kill in the Enigma, it's like, oh, whoop-de-doo. And then the rest of VP just walk straight over the top of them. That's that moment where you're just like, crap. And the hope that you can hide in the tree line, Lich just turns around and boom, you're done. You're just done. So, back to real time now. And we have Illidan battling up in the middle lane. And then Illidan, there's a jump. Holding him there. Dark Pact is not enough damage. He's got the time lapse because there's no silence coming out from any of these guys. I'm almost wondering if it's worthwhile for Scandal to try and build in towards an Orchid. I'm just wondering. Because we're going to have a side device for OD. He's building his 4-star. In fact, he's built his 4-star to start with. I wonder if it's worthwhile, if it's worth building an Orchid. Dyer's just seeing Weaver now. Under attack. Like, that could just be the Ring of Aquila. He wants to finish up. But knowing this kind of lineup, he needs to have a BKB. The BKB is essential. The Desolator After is almost just as essential. He needs survivability up against all of this magical damage, especially the stuff coming out from the OD. And then on top of that, Dyer's he also needs to ensure that he has enough damage that he can bring down that Bristleback. That's the key goal right there. So Goblike and Scandal are going to rotate towards the middle lane. Not quite sure if this is meant to be for the tier 1 tower or if they were meaning to rotate even up further. Because that top lane, there's a little bit more TPs coming in here. There's God who TP'd up there. It's a level 2 Vendetta. It's going to last for a long time. Yeah, they just came in here for the tier 1 tower. There's a lot more support rotating in, though. And they're going to be quick about this. Observers and sentries at the back end of the line. So Illidan in Light of Heaven. If they try and fight out here, Illidan's going to be very, very visible. Same with God. He can come in very, very close, but there's no stun control directly over him. OD imprisonment. Now Nyx Assassin over on the side. They saw him, but he only stunned up on top of Scandal. And Scandal ETLD is going to snap him back in. Illidan's the one they want to pick up, but they don't get it in Light of Heaven. How much bonus damage did he just have then? He took half of Slark's lifeway with one hit while Bristleback, for some reason, is battling up against Nyx Assassin on the high ground inside the Dire's Eye jungle. Arsar's Black Hole is still on cooldown for another 6 seconds as he buys up 2 levels in Necro books. Blink daggers or not, VP again, we go with the full Necro army. Problem is they sacrifice the life points and the heroes to do so. Yol, Lich ulti, Odie imprisonment. Get rid of something. He's far enough away. Yeah, it is. Dark light. Takes away that Lich ulti. Only 2 bounces. Observers and Sentry still down. The poison, it's just trying to drop Jotam's life down. It looks like he's going to be okay. Now the initiation. Yol, looking to chase it any further. He's got 7 steep charges and he's got this kill. Beating him down. Plus 150 damage. He's 6 levels up in that warpath right now. Takes the tower as well. Sergei jumps in. Sentry wards, they're all over the place. BZZ, now he's going to heal himself up. Arsar, look for the black hole. He only grabs Goblin. No, he's got Yol. It's just on the edge. Line of Heaven needs that bonus damage, but Yol comes back up again. He just keeps cool spraying out. Illidan stunned up over on the side. 4 staff up. 1 more orb attack. He can't get invis in time. Now it's VirtusPro's time to lose the team fight. Necro units are going down. Yol's hurting himself by killing him off. But he's got 3,300 gold. It's the same build as last time. We'll see if it gets as confused as last time. Or if he does just go straight into the heart in this game. Dire's middle tower is under attack. And Yol's going to be able to just tank up the creep wave while the rest of the team just beat down. Then again, he's the one that just did more damage when he starts getting that warpath up. 91 plus 100. Another quills. Ah, he's going to lose one charge. Keep that plus 100 there.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
The only downside right now is he's not next to OD, so he's not getting all of his mana back again. Now what are you going to build into, y'all? Because right now, if he wants to, he could be looking at a pipe as well. So they don't have to worry that much about the Lich ultimate. It's a nice little stat. 31 for 3 when he has more than 8 kills. It's probably also at the point when you get a Bristleback with more than 8 kills, or 8 more kills, that's... He's going Radiance. Nice! It's such a great item too. Because there's no survivability. With a hand of minus up on Weaver, again, this is VP trying to rush the Weaver into a like an early mid-game potential. But he's 1 for 3 on Illidan. He hasn't got the space required. Middle lane, Goldblack's in a lot of trouble. His ulti, however, will trigger off. Midnight Pulse won't stop him. Sergei, he's leashed up. He can't catch up to Goldblack. And with the urn charges as well, Goldblack's just got to shield himself. He's going for another urn charge. With the one charge, he stayed alive. But now the ET Spirit comes in and finishes the job. More rotation on the way in. BZZ Scandal. Is he going to try and deny this mid tower? I think he wants to leap in. And he goes on Arsat. There's no black hole. The Midnight Pulse will drop though. But Arsat's locked there. Now with the Weave going off. ET ulti snapping out. They're going to wait a little bit longer. But Arsat, Poison Touch slowing him down. And look at his negative armor. He's just got nothing left. Lich ulti will bounce up. Four staff away means this Lich ulti will now be defused. The Imprisonment does bring Slark back to the world of the living now. But VP successfully protect Arsat. That Frost Armor really kicking in for him. Even at one level, having that bonus 3 armor keeps Arsat limping back to base. 1,300 life points. Strength trades and level 2 Necro units for him. But who else is trying to get it? We got a level 3 Necro book now. In fact, sorry, I take it back. It just got done. But there's no Necro units up for anybody else. The mech gets completed up for Lich, so that's the other critical teamfight item which VP required. But they may not have enough time here. Y'all, okay, there we go. Now you see the power of the Essence Aura. He snorts and he sprays. It's 30 and 35 mana cost for these. But by doing so, he basically takes himself up to maximum mana. And now you can see him all that goes into the Bristleback. That's with the Radiance on top of him. And then rotating bottom lane. With a DD rune up on Scandal. They're not going to catch up to Light of Heaven. And Light of Heaven's just going to send the Spirit out. But this now is going to be a straight up attack on the tower. Bonus 160 damage. That's 3 points up in the warpath. Sorry, only 135 damage. 3 points up in the warpath. Yeah, a little bit more than that. What was that aura that did that? That's 135 now. 160. Mech. In range. Yep. All five. We're going high ground. 21 minutes in. Tier 2 tower's trying to be traded by VP on the top lane, but he's got to come back. Weave goes on the entire Roskis lineup too, so y'all, he'll dive the rest of the team while the rest of Roskis focus on the tower. The stomp will come, it's going to slow y'all down. Now Weave is still keeping everyone up pretty high armor, apart from y'all. Seems like he is a little bit left out. And Frost will go, still no Lich ultimate. But you got a lot of heals still there. Shadow Wave can come again. And they've still got the mech available as well. Sergei is really considering nailing on that. We got a gem. That Weave must just become visible at the last moment. Sentry Ward. A little bit further back. Radiance Burn is still picking up Illidan's life points. He's only got 910. The Radiance just takes away everything he owns. There's some movement coming around the rear. It's Arsat. Oh, wow. Scandal. Arsat, I see, attacked him. Scandal didn't cap. He didn't capitalize. He just ran back. You might be a little bit concerned that it's just jumping into the middle of a black hole. But if black hole is just used to grab Scandal, that's fine for Scandal. He'll be more than happy with that. Goblin going to leave one aggressive observer ward behind. Cedar will farm up the mid. And Scandal's going to finish up his Shadow Blade up with this top lane. Well, Yol now starts building into... It really is the same build as last time. Almost. Change up the item combination a little bit more. Well, Light of Heaven, no stun. He'll survive. Has more than enough life points to do so. Slark dying though on the top river. No Black Hole requires, just Enigma that kills him off. I assume Necro units at one point. Wasn't really seeing Enigma being close enough that he could do anything about that. There's going to be a very big concern in the camp of VirtusPro about this Bristleback. Like with this movement, Observer Ward. Oh, there's just a quick ping. Just tell him to go back. Malvasun on Gold Black. He's still got ultimate, so this kill is going to be very, very difficult. Shadow Wave making, so his ulti didn't trigger off instantly either. Necro units going to stop attacking him and Sergei. The weave's already gone off on him, but they have no vision, no detection. OD, imprisonment. It's just stopping the TP's back. Lich, wow, that orb damage. Three levels up in it. Now they go for Rasa, and he decides to convert as opposed to go for the hole. And rightly so. There was no real follow-up to help him out. The rest of VP, like, we have Light of Heaven farming up on the bottom lane. You got Illidan that's trying to push out the top lane, trying to rush into a Desolator before going into the BKB. Possibly. Jump out. Spy Carapace. It was actually the Cool Spray which ended up stunning him because of the Spy Carapace.
Radiance top,
you got the other point too, which
attack.
Is the Radiance. You'll notice how God can't stand there. 1k life points is just not enough.
Radiance structures are fortified.
And Elder Titan's back in base too. He's only got 1200.
Radiance top
and TP to top lane. Illidan's backing up. BZZ. It's like he's trying to go again for that Aghanim Scepter. He's achieved it once earlier tonight on the Dazzle. And he'll look to see if he can do it again. Sidoy starts his way into that Scythe of Ice. Actually, isn't, no, he's even elite. It's the Lincoln Sphere. It's not even a Scythe of Ice. How are they supposed to control the Weaver? Apart from just, maybe it's just this, we survive you. That could be what it all comes down to. We just survive you. Yell's coming back in. These those conversions are a little bit tankier. They have the mech as well to back him up. Having that extra armor. Yol doesn't want to let him live too long. Malifus, whoa, Yol! I know you got Negus Immortal, it's probably going to time out sometime shortly, but there's no reason to throw away your life points. While Sergei blinks up, stuns up on Sidoy. Sidoy, he's got 10 stick charges, and that's going to give him a 4-star away if he wants it. And Goldblack just gets him to life points. Shield as well, just in case. Sergei, oh, there's a Sentry Ward. They need an imprisonment or something. They've got enough damage. Onyx. Oh, Onyx. Aegis reclaim in 1 minute. With that Nyx Assassin down, they are forced to buyback. It's not going to stop Roxkiss. It just means VP have a chance to fight this on even terms. But to pick up all the spirits, Arsart still with no blink hit. He has the hole up and running. Mana's not looking too bad as well. But he's just hanging in that tree line. Same spot as last time. Yol, Aegis the Immortal. Hasn't triggered off just yet. The regeneration will still take him up to full life point, so he doesn't need to die. But it looks like he still wants to try and soak something up. He comes in close, Spire Carapace, and they do bring him down. Basic attacks to do it. Now will it be a follow-up stun? You bet your ass there will be. Oh, it missed. It was too premature. So Sergei's now lost his stun. The Enigma is still sitting over on the side. I'm watching him so closely on this minimap. Arsart refuses to come out from the side of the trees, but now he's got to. The fight is on. Odie imprisonment up once. The stomp. It slowed them down a little bit. Illidan with the BKB, already been triggered off. Scandal comes in, he sees Arsart looking for the black hole. They've already managed to bring down the Dazzle. So the big heal, the big lifeline's gone. Lich holding, bouncing around. Again, they got a split, and there's your hole! Goldblack will go back up to full life. Yo, he ran into the edge of it! Slark will run out west where the skies are blue. The tower will remain intact on the bottom lane. And the combination for VP works. As Roskis got stomped up, slowed down, they turned around back into the fight. Bristol didn't need to be in that. He did not need to be in that at all. But he committed. And you see how much it cost him. And also look at the streak, at the streets. Yeah, Yol's Bristleback, 844 gold he just gave to the Elder Titan. Does he have a Necro? Okay, that's Light of Heaven's second level Necro book. And with the time he's got to farm up in this bottom lane, he may even get himself up to that third level. Blink Dagger is also now afforded up by Arsart. That was their team fight. That was by far their team fight to take. So while we got a moment, chat trivia time. So which player now holds a record for career wins as Enigma in Pro Dota 2? With a 26-for-14 career mark. Including, wait, what? No, I lost it. I lost the end of that because there was something about milk in that. I didn't read it fast enough. Oh, scan on it. How much confidence? There's no black hole. He can take this. Dark Pack goes, Necrogens are out, so we can at least see him, but Arsat, he realizes it's all over. It's all over for him. Including 9-4 and 6.79, Melk held the record recently with 20 wins. Oh, Goblack. Trouble for him, but then ulti. Four staff up. The DD room will be taken away from them, so not really the best place to fight when you've got a Weaver with DD, but then again, it's a Weaver with only a BKB and DD. So it's not as bad as it could have been. As for the Enigma, not sure. Actually, I got a funny feeling I've had this question before. That's a funny feeling. Got him. Odin prison. Got him. Got him. Got him. Got him. Get him. Get him. Get him, son. Get him. Oh, got him. Got him. Got him, bro. Nice. T2 town. That's going to be pushed on the top lane. Because instantly I want to say Puppy. But I know Puppy hasn't played that much Enigma of late. But including the later versions, I would say Puppy.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's top
if not,
tower
it's going to be someone
fallen.
From China whose stats above. Oop! He actually got that Malphite then. Puppy's in second place. Okay, so I'm wrong. Close, but no cigar. BZZ, initiation, follow-up stun. He's got 11-1 charges and Goblet keeps him up. He's got 13 charges now. ET Yoldi won't be able to connect on anybody but Yol. He's the one in trouble. Weave, however, on most of the VP lineup. They got two heroes, in fact, being affected by it. And the Radius Burn just keeps going. Yol's shielded for the moment. But these Necro units, they are dying right now. And Yol, they keep burning off. He's going to turn, try and fight him. He's just taken out a hell of a lot of money for this. Those units are worth a lot of money. That's 150. I don't think it's for all of them. Yeah, no, it's for all of them. They were both level 3 Necro units. 150 for every single unit then. That's the downside about Necro units. They just start feeding money the way of the opponents. As you can see with the graph, like the money is most definitely going the way of Roskis. Oh, looks like our wonderful chat's also died. Yay! Not. I want my Twitch chat. I like my Twitch chat. Roskis, they like their Roshan better. Into the pit they go. And this should be a lot of... This should be very easy for him. Finally, the negative armor has arrived. The AC plus the snot. Negative 3 on the big man. And his life points just disintegrate. And there it goes. Several Sabak grabs the Aegis of the Immortal. To go with his Radiance, Assault Cuirass. And we've got Noga Club coming out. That's out for BZZ. Dave. So that's coming out, in fact, for the Dazzle. It's not even coming out, it's just staying back at base. Wouldn't be bad having those plus 10 points up in strength. And the answer is different now. Oh, Nahas. Who else has played a crap ton of Enigma? I got nothing. I got nothing right now. Puppy was the one that first came to mind. But most of the... it's got to be Southeast Asia and China, I reckon. Right now, Yol's in trouble. But he's going to, again, try and tank it up. Fly! Wow, really? Mr. Four-Man Black Hole himself! Yol running up after Sergei. They've managed to bring down the tower. Enigma does have that blink black hole. This is the thing to be more careful about. Yeah, they're even pinging it out, just saying, remember, he was over here before. As we were watching it, they used a stomp to get themselves in a position last time. But with that blink dagger on Enigma, you got to be careful. I can't believe I didn't pick Fly for the man. Orchid. Hey, would you believe that? Scandal agrees with me. And now he's going to go Arsat. There's no BKB. He can soul up Arsat before this fight begins. The stun, the heal is... Ah, is it enough? Arsat! He's so low. He's so low until that mech charge went. But meanwhile, in the bottom lane, Yol's almost finished beating down this range Rax. He's just tanking it up. There goes range Rax. Imprisonment continuing. ET ulti perfectly on Goblack as well as BZZ. Lucioli bouncing around. But there's a large amount of a creep wave here. And, well, Illidan has to time lapse out that damage. He finds himself back in the middle of the entire engagement of Roskis, so they just tanked up the entire ulti of Lich. Odie imprisonment. There's no stop this time around. And do they try and kill him? You bet your sweet ass they do. Arsene, oh, he got three on the edge! He's got three on the edge! Light him, Epic of the Spirit down too. He's bidding in a seed over the shallow grave. Is still there! He didn't pick up BZZ! And because of that, BZZ keeps most of his teammates alive. Elder Time will buy back into this game. There's still the Aegis Immortal on Yol. Living for the moment, the bottom ranks goes down. The Weave goes on four of them. They're going to have a large amount of armor to fight this up if they want to try and turn Oni Imprisonment. It's on the Weaver, the man they want. God, he's being stunned up at the moment. He gets a triple stun. Three gold, Goldblack, and BZZ. But they just sit there tanking up with 26 plus armor on BZZ, taking that tower. Desolator finally arrives on Illidan, but the bottom Rax has already gone the way of Rox Kiss. I still can't believe that he kept the Aegis Immortal alive through all of that. If Rox Kiss are fast enough, they rotate top lane and they push that out. It really just should be that simple as well. Clean up the mid on the way through, no problem. But push towards the top racks. Middle lane is something which they might consider, just so they can keep access to the Roshan pit a little bit easier if they can keep both mid and as well as the bottom down. But splitting up VP between their top as well as the bottom, that's going to be the bigger thing for him. That bottom wave is going to keep pushing out. Illidan doesn't have the life points to survive up against Super Size Me creeps. They're just going to come up the mid. They may not feel there's enough time to go up through the top. Sergei's trying to hunt up Goldblack, but he's just running himself away. And Nyx Assassin goes set to Blink Dagger Arcane. For 16 minutes, for a 16 level Nyx Assassin, he's gone 6-3-7. And that's all he's got. That almost tells most of your story right there. The advantage for Rosk is just so high up right now, and Yol, he knows it. And he's trying to push the point too. Sitting with that Reaver up in the high ground, 2.2k life points to get through, plus the Assault Cuirass. I'm still waiting for this Weave. There's your jump in, Line of Heaven. Main target from Seedoy. In with the BKB, Arsat, no Black Hole this time around. There goes your Weave. It's on the three back heroes, one of them including Yol. And watch that armor start going up. These Necro units, Shallow Grave from BZZ. He's going to heal Yol up, and Yol takes the damage too while he's in the Shallow Grave. Aegis Immortal will trigger. But for Rosk, as long as they keep getting kills here, and they can transition into the racks, that's all they really care about. Couple of Malvus stuns over to Yol again. But he's burning down these Necro units, and he picks them up too. Mid tower is still up and running. Yol's trying to get that wall path back up again too. And he jumps in. Yol, you're overcommitting. Radiance burn or not. Lich holding. Oh, the imprisonment. It's going to bounce down and back up again. It's still going to connect in, or will it? Yeah, it goes back down to Yol. Over to Goldblack. Back to Yol. Down. Oni drops the ulti on most of VirtusPro. But while Dazzle is still here, he uses the Weave again. And the armor rises again. And Desolator has no effect anymore. Fortifications back off cooldown. Slark's waiting to jump in. All five players up and running. Black Hole is available for Enigma. Arsat, you can see him. He's looping himself around. He can get three men right now. And there he goes. Jump in. Midnight Pulse. Plush a Black Hole. But there's just no follow-up. Sergei has no stun. In comes Illidan. But Seedoy. Oh, there's enough damage. Shallow Grave. Again, BZZ. Saving his life. And Illidan, he's going to get orbed down. Seedoy. This is GG. They've lost too many. They've lost too many. They've lost their racks. Yol is all over Light of Heaven like a hot rash. God will go down as well inside. It's a triple kill. Give him an ultra. Give him an ultra. Nah, you don't get it. GG, well played. Rox Kiss will take home the 1,250 euro courtesy of EIZO. And the 250 will go the way of VirtusPro. Congratulations to both the teams. It's the all-Russian final. And sorry, it's 500 going the way of VirtusPro. So congratulations, Roskits will claim the title of the EIZO Cup. If you want the details and all the VODs for all this kind of stuff, you can check the details over at EIZO-Cup.com. Click the Dota link and off you go. You can also find all the VODs for everything we cast here at joinDOTA over at youtube.com/joinDOTA. And you can follow me at TobiWanDOTA as well. All of that wonderful information coming your way. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned, though. If you want us to watch the 1v1 battle, it'll be coming up in just a couple of moments' time. And it's going to be fun, peoples. It's going to be fun. Check your emails. I'll be hosting at the lobby in a couple of moments' time. Your email should contain the password. It should contain the password for your game. If you are one of the 8 people that got emailed, the first person to the lobby, the number one slot, face up against me in just a couple of moments' time. Thanks for watching the EIZO Cup. We'll see you next time.